If you love skywatching, you can mark dates in your calendar, so you don't miss the chance to look for the extra bright, beautiful moon on these days. The night sky highlights include 4 full supermoons in a row, also include a rare blue moon. The full moon is known as a supermoon when it becomes fully illuminated around the same time that it reaches perigee, or its closest point to Earth on its monthly orbit. This synchronism happens just a few times each year and can cause the moon to appear quite a bit brighter in the sky. The sun is about 50,000 miles closer to the Earth than at its furthest point. And it's a full or new moon, the moon will appear larger and brighter than most full moons. To be considered a supermoon, it has to be within 224,851 miles of our planet, as measured from the centers of the moon and Earth. The supermoon being close to the perigee is visible through the naked eye. NASA recommends using a pair of binoculars with a minimum magnification of 7 and a tripod with the binoculars at a magnification of 10 or 15. When a supermoon occurs, the moon can appear up to 14% larger and 30% brighter than when it is at its farthest point from Earth. While the difference in size and brightness may not be easily noticeable to the casual observer, supermoons attract attention due to their slightly more prominent and striking appearance in the night sky. Many people talk about the effects of a supermoon on us and our planet. But there is scant scientific evidence to support claims that supermoons cause earthquakes, volcanic eruptions, extreme weather and tsunamis, or floods and pestilence. The moon is, of course, the driving force for Earth's tides. Full and new moons are when the Earth, Sun, and Moon line up to produce extreme spring tides. But the effect of perigean spring tides only increases the tidal variations by about 5 centimeters on average. In recent years, there have indeed been a handful of tsunamis and earthquakes that coincided with a supermoon, but with around 3 supermoons every 14 months, it would be unusual if such a disaster did not coincide with a supermoon now and then. On average, there are 3 to 4 supermoons in a year. However, the actual number can change. It depends on the specific criteria used to define a supermoon, as well as the variations in the moon's orbit. Thanks to an optical illusion in the sky, the moon will appear bigger and brighter than normal in the Bay Area in the night, during what astronomers call a supermoon. Because the sun is about 50,000 miles closer to the Earth than at its furthest point, and it's a full or new moon, the moon will appear larger and brighter than most full moons. To be considered a supermoon, it has to be within 224,851 miles of our planet, as measured from the centers of the moon and Earth. A supermoon may not be so super or even rare, but once you cut through the hype, it is still a great way to engage with our nearest celestial neighbor. For more on lunar gazing, watch our guide on where and how to observe the moon. The first supermoon of the year will occur on August 19, 2024. August's full moon is known as the Sturgeon moon. August's full moon is called the full sturgeon moon, after the primitive fish that used to be abundant in North America's lakes and rivers during the summer months. This supermoon is unique because it's a special seasonal blue moon, and it will be the last blue moon until May 20, 2027. What is a blue moon? There are 2 types of blue moons, seasonal and monthly. A seasonal one is the 3rd full moon of an astronomical season that has 4 full moons and happens between the summer solstice and the fall equinox, according to NASA. A monthly blue moon is the 2nd full moon in a month that features 2 full moons. The 2nd supermoon of the year will occur on Wednesday, September 18. September's full moon is known as the full harvest moon, as it is the full moon that is closest to the fall equinox. In the northern hemisphere, the full harvest moon rises very soon after sunset, providing plenty of bright light for farmers harvesting their summer crops. September's full moon is so well known for its luminosity and brilliance that certain Native American tribes even named it the Big Moon. The full harvest moon holds major cultural significance in many different communities, who spend this full moon not just celebrating the fall harvest, but also the moon itself. On October 17, 2024, there will be a Super Hunter's Moon. Plus, it's also the biggest supermoon of the year. Which means the moon will come closer to the Earth than any other full moon in 2024. At the moment of perigee, the distance between them will be 357,364 kilometers. For comparison, the average distance between the Earth and the moon is 384,400 kilometers. The last supermoon of the year will occur on Friday, November 15. There is disagreement over the origin of November's beaver moon name. Some say it comes from Native Americans setting beaver traps during this month. While others say the name comes from the heavy activity of beavers building their winter dams. Another name is the frost moon. One lunar phenomenon that is often considered rare and noteworthy is the blue moon. A typical lunar cycle is about 29.5 days and most months only have enough time for one full moon. The gravitational force of the moon causes many visible changes on Earth, affecting the ocean's tides, animals' migration habits and humans' ability to sleep. Full moons have been heralded to have the most influence. We'll see four supermoons this year. Starting off with a special seasonal blue moon on August 19th. The other full supermoons will occur on September 18th. October 17th and November 15th, 2024. Now you can mark these dates in your 2024 calendar so you don't miss the chance to look for the extra bright, beautiful moon on these days. The best time to observe the supermoon is when the moon is near the horizon during either moonrise or moonset. Thanks to having objects in the foreground to provide reference points for estimating the moon's size. So don't miss to watch such beautiful view in the night sky.